Alright guys, I'm up here in the woods. You can see the deer have been scrounging for stuff to eat. See, I got trees cut down. I dropped a couple weeks ago before we got snow. I'm going to start cutting these up. You can see these, where all these, thorn bushes and stuff were. I've got them all thinned out. Had a lot of brush to move, but that'll wait till spring with the skid loader when I got the tracks on. We'll pile it all up. But today, I am going to drop more trees on the ground and get as many blocked up as I can, so I can just run up here with the skid loader, fill the bucket, and be good. I do have the trailer for the gator too, but before too long I won't be able to make it up this hill with the gator. The skid loader, I have a set of chains I put on the back tires, and I can really get around good with him. It takes a lot of snow to slow him down with those chains on, so but as you can see, we got a bunch of trees dropped here, so that one there I'm gonna have to grab with a skid loader and pull him down. But you can see here, I had mentioned in one of the other videos, I had some of these trees marked to thin them just because they're too close together and they're going to be too much shade. And the roots steal too much from the grass, so you kind of got to spread them out so they're more opening between them. But there's not a lot of trees left in this side to cut right now. There's a few, but there's a crooked box elder that needs to come down. I hate box elder. And down here we've got those poplar, whatever you want to call them. There's a couple of them in there that need to get cut and drug out. But otherwise, a lot of the smaller stuff is just going to get cut and dropped, or I use the steel brush cutter during the summer and continue thinning on that. Yeah, I look at all these deer tracks everywhere. So this is what I'm working on. Let's say just trying to get open more. What I might end up doing is the same as last summer, feeding bales up here in certain spots, trying to get grass established and growing. And if you guys look down here, you can see that green winter eye poking out through the snow. This is where I was feeding those bales. So there'll be something growing there for a while. Hopefully the grass seed that I spread out there with it will start to grow. And some of the grass seed that was hopefully in those bales of hay that we fed. Yeah, this is what's going on. It's about 24 degrees right now. So nothing better than come up here and work up a sweat cutting down firewood and cutting down trees. The worst part about my cutting here is that dang power line that runs up through there. It's a dead power line. It dead ends right here at the bottom of the hill. And then actually it runs across the road, goes about a half mile up the side road up there, and then it dead ends up there. And how I know that it's dead end, obviously it's cut down here and there's nothing at the end of it. And at that end, they have it tied to a T-post. So it's a dead utility line. It'd be real nice if they just get it the heck out of here. I don't care if they leave the poles. It'd be nice to have the wire gone because trees get stuck in it. And then you gotta come up here with a tractor, the skid loader, and a chain and jerk the trees out of them. So, and I bought this farm in 04. And this was all grass through here. This is how much this has grew up in this right-of-way. Like, you can see I'm underneath the power lines right now. This right-of-way was 40 feet wide or whatever, and it was all grass. This is how much of stuff has grown up in 12 years. So yeah, kind of a pain in my butt, but it is what it is. A couple deer beds right there. But as you can see, I have a lot of bigger trees I need to get cut down. A lot of these other ones need to get thinned out. So that's what we're gonna work on. Just continue dropping trees and cutting them up, and then I just come out every day with a skid loader and grab a bucket or two and go from there. If we get a warmer day, I'll make a whole day of it, but I usually try to come out and cut a bunch of stuff up and then dig it out of the snow as I need it, which sounds kind of foolish, I know, but that's just the way I do it. So this is what it's looking like, slow progress. You know, and I just cut this tree down before it snowed. We get these all cut up. Get the blocks of wood out of here and then take all this brush and push it down into the piles. Go from there. So that's what it's looking like up here. I do get some things done. Not always the most productive, but we'll get there slowly. Rome wasn't built in a day. So, but anyhow, that's what she's looking like. A little bit at a time. So anyways, guys, I think that'll do it for this video. I just wanted to show you quick what it looks like up here in the winter when I'm working, cutting trees down. Getting there slowly. And normally, I leave these stumps higher so I can see them with the gator, with a skid loader. If you cut them down here, the gator gets hung up on them, so it's just as easy to leave them higher so you can see them. So I'm kind of keeping my eye out for a grinder. Actually, it's called a forestry mulcher, but the problem with them are you need a high. There is one unit that has a low hydraulic flow, but the ones I'm looking at require high flow, and I don't have a high flow skid loader yet. So there is a place I can rent one, and with those I can take the stump all the way down below the ground. So once I upgrade skid loader, get a second skid loader that's bigger, I'm going to rent one of those or buy one for cleaning this up. But there's got to be a lot of trees cut up first. So anyways, that's enough rambling on about that. So anyways, that's what she's looking like in our winter wonderland here. So anyways, comment, rate, subscribe, stay tuned for more, and as always, I will catch you on the next one. Alright guys, one more quick update here before I end this video. As you can see, I dropped a bunch more trees here. Dropped a bunch. Blocked a couple up that were going to get covered up by other trees when they fell. As you can see down there, there's a pile of trees. I dropped a bunch of trees over here. I dropped a bunch on that side of the driveway. I have one right there that I read wrong. Actually, I put my back cut in there wrong, and it wants to tip uphill. So I'm going to leave them for a windy day, and hopefully the wind takes them down. So I'm kind of done in this area for right now. Anyways, I got this big one that you guys have seen during the summer. Cut into smaller pieces so I can grab the pallet forks and lift them up and get him out of here, this old oak one. And grab him with the pallet forks. Must be road hunting. But once this maple tree right here, this one right here, once that one falls, I'm gonna cut these last two down. And there's a big oak tree right here. I'm gonna leave him, and there's an oak next to him. I'm gonna leave that one. I'm gonna cut them two maple down right there. Another maple here. there's a big ash in there that needs to come down. I'm just kind of gonna work around the outside, keep working around, cutting out what I want, leaving what I want to stay. I'm trying to leave a lot of the oak and thin out everything else. And I'll leave some maple throughout. My biggest thing is I want my maples on the south side of the hill, because they start running earlier in the spring. So I really don't need any maple trees on this side of the hill. Pretty much I'm just trying to get oaks everywhere except for right there. I want to leave my maple stand there. There's 30 some trees in there that I tap, normally only tap about 15 of them, but there's 30, somewhere between 30 and 50 of them along that side there that I can tap, and it's great plenty. So I really don't need maple trees all over throughout this. The biggest thing is I want the oaks to start growing, because oaks, roots go down deeper, and they don't necessarily steal quite as much water from the grass as the other trees do that have shallower roots. So that's kind of what's going on here. This is what it's looking like. It's getting open up more and more. If that tree, see, I put my notch in there, but when I was coming with my back cut, I was cutting at an angle, and my angle went down too far, and the tree wanted to come the wrong way, so I didn't have my wedges with me, so I'm going to leave them. If we get, we're supposed to get wind tomorrow. That's why I'm dropping trees today and not cutting, blocking a whole lot, because I can block them once they're on the ground. Biggest thing is dropping them right now when there's no wind. So, but he'll get a full blast of wind here one of these days out of the north or whatever. That'll take him out. And then I can drop some more in there. But I want to get this area open up going down along my driveway so I get good grass growing there. And then, let me see, we'll keep working around the edges. So, anyways, enough blabbering. That's what's going on. Comment, rate, subscribe. Stay tuned for more. And as always, I will catch you on the next one.